Daniel Sedin with his 14th career overtime goal. The streak is over. Henrik Sedin skated by the Florida bench and had words, and now Dorsett is challenging Al Montoya.
And here look we go. Out. Look out, Scout.
You haven't seen this in a while. Henrik Sedin appeared to start this right after the goal went in. He went to the Florida bench, had words, and now we have trouble brewing.
Oh, this is old-time hockey.
Panthers coming back from the dressing room. I don't know who Henrik was talking to. And Luongo having words now through the pile, and we're not done yet.
And some of the Canucks have gone already. The coaching staff in particular, Glenn Collison's out there trying to calm down his crew.
Gerard
Glanson was in a testy mood after last night's game, and you can see now this is continuing.
This
Ryan Miller's involved.
They'll be here.
Well, Al Montoya was one of the guys, and when the backup goalie gets involved, that's where Ryan Miller's talking to Al Montoya right now.
And Gerard Gallant is being held back by the linesman.
And you can see Gerard Gallant. Yeah. They look at Glenn Gullickson now, and Gerard Gallant, they're going at it verbally.
I don't know how many people saw the initial fly by the bench from the Canuck captain. And I don't know who he was talking to while the rest of the Canucks were celebrating at center ice. And that seemed to spark everything.
And you can see Henrik Sedin now is trying to wave the Canucks off after a big win. And another come from behind win, John, where they hadn't before this homestand, they hadn't come from behind the entire season. And they've done it twice now in these seven games.
The streak is over for the Panthers. It ends at 12. And it ends with some tension. And Gerard Gallant still trying to calm down. We have a winner on Score and Win thanks to the overtime goal. William Byrd of Powell River on behalf of Safeway and Quaker Crispy Minis or Rice Cakes. You want a Lagostina 8-piece cookware set.
And we'll get another look at the overtime goal. I don't know whether Henrik Sedin just provided the screen. I think he did. I don't think he tipped that one, but a beautiful screen it was. Henrik to Daniel. And Daniel circles right in the middle. And Henrik goes right to the middle, and you can see Henrik waving at it. Roberto doesn't see it.
And this is when all heck started to break loose.
And there it was.
And it took a while for this to come to an end. And you can bet the league will be making some phone calls to get to the bottom of this.